expect to see a moving dinosaur blocking the path.
Dinosaurs!
Remember, Muck, they're not real.
If you say so, Leo.
Leo, come see what we've found.
Hey, Scoop! Scoop! What have you found?
Oh, Muck, what have you done?
I'm sorry, Bob. I forgot that it was only a model. I thought it was real. It definitely sounded real.
Why was the Triceratops in the middle of the path, guys?
Sorry, Bob. We weren't trying to scare Muck. We just wanted to surprise Leo.
He said he was scared of dinosaurs.
But I grew out of that a long time ago, Lofty.
Now we've lost the Dino Park's main attraction.
Huh?
And there isn't much time before Mayor Madison arrives.
Bob, look!
Don't go too close to the edge, Scoop.
The Triceratops is only halfway down the cliff, and in one piece.
If we can reach it, we can still get the park finished in time.
But how? It's a long way down.
I'll rappel down the cliff.
Awesome.
Okay, Scoop. You'll be my anchor. So you need to stay still and keep your brakes on.
Understood, Bob.
Lofty, you lower your hook when I say.
Yes, Bob.
Okay, Lofty, you can lower it down.
Righto.
Take us up, Lofty.
It's a dinosaur riding cowboy!
We did it!
It's not over yet, Lofty. We need to hurry and get this park finished. Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
Fantastic!
I've just had a thought, though. Could it have a door? A door that opens so that Sphinx robots can appear out of it. Oh, that would be fabulous, if it's possible.
Not a problem, Carl. If you can imagine it, I can build it.
I quit, Scoop. I'm obviously not meant to be an actor.
What? I think you're brilliant, Leo! Hey, look, there's Safi!
Good luck in the film, Leo!
How am I ever gonna tell her I'm not in it?
Do you want me to tell her, Leo?
Beep, bop, bop, beep!
Let's not tell her yet, Scoop. Remember, anything can happen in the movies.
Have you seen Leo?
Not for a while, Scoop.
Oh.
Around here, Carl. Is this where you want the big robot?
That's perfect, Bob.
Okay, Lofty. He's heavy, so lift gently. Then bring him towards me. And stop. And slowly bring him down. Down. Yes, just here. Excellent work, Lofty.
Ooh, how exciting.
Hi, you two. You haven't seen Leo, have you?
Yeah, loads of times.
He means this morning, Muck.
Oh. No.
Me neither, Scoop.
Okay, everyone, we're about to start making Space Robots 3. Everybody ready? Great. Here we go.
Silly, I'd say. We shouldn't be up there. It's dangerous.
Oh, careful of my rocket!
Hey, Lofty! There aren't any fish at all!
Be careful of the water, Scoop!
I'm not afraid of water! Look!
What is it?
I think there's something in my rear bucket.
It's a fish. Leo was right all along.
Is it a big one with a gigantic mouth full of ugly teeth and spikes down its back?
Well, I don't like to be rude, but yes.
Ah! Help me! Something! Help me!
Looks like we'll finish the bridge just in time for the race.
Who do you think's gonna win?
I don't know, but Sky Sampson wins it most years.
Come on, let's go back to work, or there'll be no bridge to run across at all.
Whoa!
Get it off! Fish! Get off! It's flopping around!
Watch out, Scoop! Slow down!
Oh, thank goodness it's gone.
What's going on?
Whoa! I'm gonna fall in! Help!
It's okay, Lofty. You're not gonna fall. Stay calm. Slowly drive forward.
It's not working! Bob!
None of Lofty's wheels are touching the ground, Bob.
What are we gonna do?
It's a shame we can't just reel him in like a fish.
Hang on a minute. That gives me an idea. Lofty, don't move. Just do exactly what I say.
Mm-hmm.
Scoop, come forward really slowly so that your front bucket is below Lofty's hook.
Uh-huh.
Lofty, let your hook drop so Scoop can carry it. Wendy, Leo, go with Scoop and attach Lofty's hook to the base of the spar. You'll be fine, Lofty.
Ready, Bob!
Okay, stand back now. Now, Lofty, start pulling your hook in really slowly. That's it, you're doing fine. And now drive forward very gently.
Yeah!
Well done, Lofty.
Thank you, Bob.
I'm sorry, Lofty. I shouldn't have been messing around by the river. I put Lofty in danger, and we've lost part of the bridge. The race will be ruined now.
Don't worry, Scoop. You helped put things right, too.
Did I?
Leo, what are you doing?
Trying to find my notes on what to do in an emergency. Come on, Leo. Focus. Okay. First, I need to stop the train.
But how?
Maglev 1, this is Leo. The track's broken. Brake now. Brake now.
Warning received loud and clear. Applying brakes now.
Thank you.
I am so sorry. I put the team in danger. All because I couldn't concentrate on one job at a time.
You managed it in the end.
And saved the train!
But what are we gonna do about the station and the track?
There's just enough time before the train makes its first journey. So, can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
Yes, we can!
Driver, please.
Wow! Look at it go!
Amazing.
Bob, why aren't you on the train?
I lost my ticket.
Bob!
Is there snow yet?
Not yet. Once the liquid is in, the machines need to be switched on.
Ooh, then is there snow?
Not quite. The machines stir up the liquid to make tiny white bubbles that stick together, and that makes the pretend snow.
All done. Do you two want to go down and watch the snow fall over the tree?
Woo-hoo! I'm gonna see it snow!
I think that's a yes from Leo.
Display is almost finished, and I still haven't given Bob his present.
We're going to test the snow machines. Are you coming to watch?
Oh, yeah, sure am.
Definitely.
I'll be there in a minute.
Oh, Lofty, please don't mess up the display again.
I won't. I'd love to give Bob his Christmas present when it's actually snowing. It. There!
Okay, Wendy, make it snow in 3, 2...
Timber!
Stay there, everyone! Do not move!
What do I do?
Move to your right, now!
Wasn't supposed to happen, was it?
The display! It's ruined!
Oh, dear.
There's usually a good reason why we've stopped.
Oh, You're right. I got carried away trying to raise Scoop.
Is Scoop still digging?
Yes, faster than ever. Scoop! You can stop digging now! I've stopped! You win!
Nice try, Muck, but I'm not falling for that one! You just want me to stop, so you can win!
No! I don't care about losing the challenge!
Well, I do!
I've been waiting ages to get this build started!
I know the feeling.
These are exciting times for Spring City!
Bob?
Nothing says busy bustling business like a skyscraper does! Bob? Wendy?
You've gone much too deep, Scoop. I said as deep as 3 school buses, remember?
You could fit a whole fleet of buses in there.
Right. Let's see what you've hit. It looks like some kind of wall.
Let's just fill the hole up again.
Sorry, Muck, but when you find something unexpected in the ground, you have to stop work.
It's hard to tell for certain, but this wall could be really old and special.
I'll go and call Anish Bose, the archaeologist.
The archaeologist?
Archaeologist. They're people who help teach us about the olden days by finding things that have been buried underground for hundreds of years.
Huh?
They're experts in digging stuff up.
I thought that was me.
I think you've done enough digging for today, Scoop.
Yes, there is no doubt. This is one of the most exciting discoveries in years. This is extremely
bad news.
Underneath this earth lies the remains of a wall from Roman times. From a fort or a villa, probably.
Oh, Roman! What's that?
The Romans were people who lived here about 2,000 years ago. They were excellent builders.
Ooh, just like us.
Talking of building, Professor Bose, when can we get building again?
Well, hard to say. But this dig is going to take at least a month.
A month?
That's ages! I did all that in just one morning!
Aha! But unlike you, we have to dig very slowly and very carefully.
No wonder it takes so long. Your brushes are way too tiny.
Wow, Leo, you're amazing!
Looks like I'll need a bigger wrench. Hi, Roland.
Hi, Bob. I got bad news. The weather forecast says there's a giant snowstorm on the way.
Oh, dear. That means more snow on the roads.
Exactly. It's gonna take my delivery vans a lot longer to get the gifts to my customers. So now, I need everything ready by 7 o'clock this evening.
Don't worry, Roland. We'll have it all up and running in time.
You probably shouldn't be doing that without using the manual.
It's all right, Lofty. I know all about robotics. Look, I'm making Rudolph fly.
Come in, Leo. Come in, Leo.
Oh, hi, Bob.
Listen, there's a storm coming. We need to have the picking system up and running by this evening.
Oh, really? Okay.
I need you back up here, quick. Oh, and can you bring up my 1¼-inch wrench?
Sure thing.
Great. Thanks, Leo.
Look, I'm a robot picker arm.
No, you're not. Look at me.
Okay, that's enough fun, you two. We need to get back to work. I'm switching it off.
But you've jumbled up all the toys, Leo. They're all in the wrong places.
That's okay. I'll put them back. Okay, so this teddy here goes back here on the teddy shelf. Oh, no. There's a skateboard and a jigsaw on the teddy shelf.
Where's the skateboard shelf?
I don't know.
Where's the jigsaw shelf?
What's wrong?
Nothing. I'm just a tiny bit confused. Oh, no!
Why don't you press the undo button a few times?
That's a good idea, Scoop.
Oh, I think it's woken up.
Uh-oh. This is very bad. I've never seen Leo move so quickly.
Come on, Leo, where are you? I really need that wrench.
Hey, Bob!
there you are. Have you got my... wrench?
No, because a robot arm got me!
How to get those horses back. Wendy, Leo, get ready to close the paddock gate. Scoop, come with me. Come on, partner. Let's head them off at the pass.
Hey? Well, not you too, Bob. You're talking nonsense like Leo.
Sorry, Scoop. Just head for that gap in the fence.
Bob, how am I meant to keep up with racehorses? Especially extra fast, extra difficult to catch ones.
We're not gonna race them. We're going to use our own talents. Remember, they're also extra nervous and scared of machine noise.
Oh, yeah.
Hold up, Scoop. Wait for my signal. Now, let's go! Work, partner. That was extra noisy and extra brilliant.
You know, Bob, I think I might be a thoroughbred machine.
Here they come.
Ready, Leo? This is your chance to be a real cowboy and round up those horses.
And they're in top gear.
Don't worry, I grew up with horses. Here's what we're going to do. Lofty, extend your crane arm as far as you can and as fast as you can. We're going to make a barrier and steer them back into their paddock. It's not fast enough. It's not going to reach in time.
I didn't know you grew up with horses, Wendy.
Oh, yes, I rode them all the time. Wooden ones, on the merry-go-round.
Huh? They seem to like it, though.
Yeah, and as soon as their new pool is ready, we'll take them back to the zoo. Perfect.
As you can see, this magnificent stadium is Spring City's pride and joy.
And home to some of our greatest sporting triumphs.
I'm not very keen on sports. Lots of running around, jumping, kicking balls, not my thing.
Okay, right. You don't like sports. But I think we have something you definitely will like.
We do, don't we, Mr. Bentley?
Yes, yes. This one is sure to be a winner.
Here's the new window, Bob!
Excellent. Okay, everyone. We need to get those penguins into their new pool as soon as possible. Can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
One, Scoop.
Oh, not that way. No, stay away from the road.
Stop. Oh, it's lucky Mayor Madison isn't around to see all this.
It's okay, Scoop. She won't be back for hours. As soon as that window's fixed, we can get these penguins back to the zoo.
Whoa, not over there. Hey, get back in the pond. Hey, you.
Welcome to the Flying Saucepan. The finest food with the best views in Spring City. Can I get you a wee bite to eat?
This building, it appears to be moving.
Exactly. It's a revolving restaurant.
A magnificent miracle of mechanical engineering. Fancy a plate of haggis and beets.
Oh, I feel sick.
Oh, dear. Maybe we'd better cut short the visit and get you back to Town Hall. This visit has been a complete disaster. I thought you said nothing could go wrong.
Maybe he would like an ice cream?
Oh, I wish that penguin pool was ready!
This reminds me of my time in South America.
Where's Bob? What's happening?
Are you okay up there?
We're fine, Bob!
This is awesome!
Hold on tight! I'm gonna have to hit the emergency brake!
But Bob, the closest brake is all the way down at the base terminal.
Then there's only one way.
Here you go, Bob! Go, Bob!
But watch out for my snowman! I just wanted to have fun on the snow like everyone else. Maybe I could make it up to you by building you a really big jump.
Yes, please. That would be totally
extreme.
Yeah.
Sounds like a plan, Scoop. We'll set up the night skiing lights while you build the jump. Let's go.
A very warm welcome to the Winter in Spring Festival!
First prize in the snowman contest. Meet Snow Bob. It's modeled on you.
It's like looking in a mirror.
Hey, super snowboarding, Bob. You caught some big air up there.
Thanks, Sky. Maybe winter's not so bad after all. Although I'm still looking forward to summer.
Great. Then I can teach you how to water ski.
Oh, right.
Well done, Leo. Finish the support frame all by yourself. Now all we need is the TV.
Oh, yes, my dear.
Sorry, guys, but the TV needs to be turned off now. Wendy, we need to take the TV to the stadium. Wendy!
Bob! Where have you been? We need to take the TV to the stadium.
Now we have everything to cheer for Mila. Thanks, Lofty.
Oh, that'll be two-ton with a giant TV screen.
Lofty, get ready to lift the screen.
And I'll make sure that Mayor Madison and the Spring City Rockets keep back.
Thank you. screen towards the brain. There. And finally, we can take away the scaffold towers.
That all looks nice and sturdy.
Quick! The screen is falling!
The supports are falling too!
Don't worry, I'll help!
Quick, everyone! Let's move to a safe distance!
Now the frame is breaking!
What happened? Why did the supports come away from the frame? And why did the frame break?
It wasn't Leo's fault. It was mine. I left Leo without any help because I wanted to help the Spring City Rockets instead. I am so sorry.
But it is my fault. I never should have tried to do such a big job by myself.
Oh, no! Mr. D'Souza, I'm so sorry. I should have known I was too big and clumsy to go near a dance floor, let alone dance on one. Please let me fix this for you.
It was an accident.
And he really does want to dance.
Don't tell anyone, but when I was a boy, I was a little bit, not the right shape or size for dancing. Always knocking into things.
Really? That's just like me.
But I wanted to dance more than anything in my life. I refused to admit defeat. And I practiced and practiced until I became the superstar I am today. Never give up on your dreams, Lofty. Alors, my dance floor, can you really fix it?
Yes, we can. It's so beautiful.
It's perfect. I need to get ready for my performance now. Thank you all. And you must remember always to follow your dreams.
Yoo-hoo! Sylvan! Where's my dressing room? I've been practicing all day! Look! Dum-dee-dum-dum-dee! Ah! My ankle!
You cannot dance on this, Maria.
Oh, dear me.
I have no other dance to open the show.
Ow!
Quel désastre!
Wendy can dance.
You can?
Bob!
Wow, Wendy! You're a pro!
I won a few awards at high school. You just need to practice.
What have you done this time?
I'm sorry, Bob. I just wanted to be like Sky and break a record.
Well, you definitely broke something.
Oh, dear. The fun run starts in an hour, and we haven't even finished the rope bridge.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
The game's not over just yet, team. We can fix this if we all rely on our best abilities. Lofty, I'll need your amazing weightlifting strength.
Sure thing, Bob.
And Muck, I'll need your powerful bucket.
No sweat.
What's wrong, Scoop?
Oh, I messed up everything for Sky's fun run. And I wasn't very good at sports either.
And Scoop?
Yes, Bob?
You're an all-round all-star. I'll need your speed, ability, and digging power.
Yes, Bob!
Can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
That's the sporting spirit!
The most important thing about a fun run is to have fun! And eat your broccoli. Go!
You can win this, Wendy!
Bye, Dad!
I should have worn a sweatsuit at all!
Impressive ropecraft, if I do say so myself.
Hooray! Congratulations, everyone! And as for you, young Scoop...
Oh, wow! What's this for?
You set a new record! The tire toss over a street lamp!
You mean... I'm a world champion! Awesome!
Three cheers for Scoop! Hip, hip!
The mountain looks quite high to me, Scoop.
Real mountains are 100 times bigger, and we need to make this as real as possible. You wouldn't want the bear to be sad, would you, Lofty?
No, of course not.
Then let's build it bigger.
I suppose a bit more won't hurt.
One more rock!
One more bucketful!
Don't worry, Jenny. We're way ahead of schedule. We'll finish the enclosure in time.
Hi, Bob. We brought a few more trees than I planned.
Somebody couldn't choose between one tree and another.
So we took both. And we got blackberry and blueberry bushes, too.
Good choices. Bears love berries.
We'll be done soon, Jenny.
I'm looking forward to seeing it.
One more rock.
One more pallet.
Just one more tiny bucketful.
Stop! The mountain can't take anymore.
That wasn't supposed to happen, was it?
Oops. The bear's arriving on the next plane. Are you ready? Are you? Oh! Bob, where did the bear's habitat go?
Oh.
Don't worry, Jenny. Just a little mix-up with the foundations. Bob will make it right.
What happened, Scoop?
I'm so sorry, Bob. I just wanted to give the big, fierce mountain bear a big, tall mountain to live on so that it would be happy.
Sorry, Bob.
I'm really sorry too, Bob. I should have known better.
No, Lofty. I persuaded you to build it higher. I'm sorry. It really is all my fault.
Jenny's in a panic. I hope you have a backup plan, Bob.
I didn't design the mountain to be as tall as Scoop wanted. But I do like his idea.
Awesome!
Yes, and?
If we use shingle and concrete as the base instead of shingle and soil, we could build 4 different levels instead of 3. Can you bring us some quick-drying concrete, Two-Ton?
I can bring some now, Bob, before I collect the bear.
Thanks, Two-Ton.
You're very welcome.
And then we'll all have to work extra hard to get it finished.
We will, Bob.
Anything you say.
You can count on us.
Can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
If you're waiting for a dinosaur, it's your lucky day. I've got a really large one here.
Amazing!
Very impressive. Lovely bone structure.
Okay, let's get it inside.
Oh, careful now. That skeleton is 65 million years old.
Thank goodness it's not a new one.
Easy does it.
Hold it still a minute. I gotta get some pictures. Beautiful! That doesn't look right.
That is never going to get through there.
What? But I gave you the exact measurements. What have you done?
You told Bob the doors had to be 6 yards wide and 3 yards high.
Yes. No. I meant to say 6 yards high and 3 yards wide. Oh, dear me.
Uh-oh. This is very bad.
The door is too short and the dinosaur is too tall. It's never going to fit inside.
But it has to. Mayor Madison is coming soon to make sure everything's ready for tomorrow's opening.
But there's no way that dinosaur is going to get through those doors.
What about sideways?
Scoop.
There might be a way. If we take the skeleton apart, we can carry all the bones inside, then put them back together again.
I don't think that's such a good idea, Lofty. We shouldn't do anything drastic till Bob gets back.
But it's getting late, and Mayor Madison will be here soon.
I think it's a brilliant idea, Lofty. Come along, everyone. There's a T-Rex to take apart. This thing is so fiddly.
I think this one goes up here.
Oh, dear.
No, I can't be right. Maybe this one.
No. You've got it all wrong. Oh, this large one must be part of the leg. So it must go here. Doesn't seem to fit. What about this small one, then? It's part of the tail, isn't it? Or maybe the left foot? No?
What on earth?